The Old Man and the Cherry Trees. Long, long ago, in a tidy little house with a neat little garden, there lived an old couple and their faithful dog, Jiro. He was a very well-behaved animal, and every evening he would wait patiently on the veranda for his master to give him scraps from his dinner. But in the big, dark house next door, there lived a very nasty neighbor who hated dogs. Sometimes, when he noticed Jiro waiting for his dinner, he would throw stones at him. Often he hit the poor dog, and it would yelp with pain. But its master was a very humble man and was afraid to complain. One hot summer evening, while the couple were having their dinner in the house, Jiro began barking excitedly.
"Whatever's happening?" said the old man. "Is that our nasty neighbour throwing stones again? I'll go and see."
He slid back the doors and was most surprised when the dog seized the bottom of his kimono with its teeth and began to pull him towards the old cherry tree which grew in their garden. When they reached it, Jiro began digging frantically, all the time looking up at his master. The old man thought to himself,
There must be something special down there.
And he rushed off to get his spade. Then he began digging too, and soon he hit a big black box with his spade.
"Oh, quickly, quickly," he shouted to his wife. Look what I found."
His wife rushed out, and together they opened the heavy lid. The box was full to the brim with gold and silver coins. Happily, they went back to the house, carrying all the treasure, not noticing that the nasty neighbour was watching them through the bamboo fence. The old man gave Jiro a huge dinner and said,
Now we are rich. Jiro, what a wonderful dog you are. It's just like something from a fairy tale.
Meanwhile, the nasty neighbour was thinking up a nasty plan. Early next morning, he called round at the old couple's house.
"Good morning, old man. How are you this fine morning?"
The old man was rather surprised by these friendly words. He replied politely,
Very well, thank you. Although my back is a bit stiff today.
"Oh, what a pity. Can I do anything to help you, like taking your dog for a walk? Although I have always been unfriendly to him, I'd like to become friends now that he doesn't bark so much as he used to."
The old man hesitated, but as the neighbour seemed to be friendly after all, he fetched Jiro to the door. He growled at the neighbour, who just smiled and took the lead. Off they went next door. As soon as they were inside, the neighbour shouted at Jiro.
"All right, you clever dog. I saw what you did in your master's garden. There must be gold in mine as well. Where is it?"
He dragged the dog into the garden, where there was a dead pine tree, and pushed the dog's nose to the ground. The poor animal started digging again, and the nasty neighbour ran for his spade. Down and down they dug until the spade struck something hard. It was an old iron box. The neighbour dragged it out of the hole and threw back the rusty lid. Inside was nothing but a rotting pile of slugs, snails, and worms. The neighbour staggered back.
"You beastly dog! Take that and that!"
He hit the dog with his spade until it was dead at his feet. Then he threw its body into the hole and buried it. The next morning, the old couple were worrying about Jiro.
I wonder what can have happened to him. I'll go and see the neighbour.
So he went round and knocked on the neighbour's door.
Yes?
Excuse me, but could we have Jiro back, please?
Jiro? Who's Jiro?
Oh, he's our dog. We lent him to you yesterday.
Your dog? Oh, it's dead.
Dead? Oh, but what happened?
Oh, it attacked me, so I had to kill it.
The old man could not speak for a few moments, but then said,
What about his body?
Well, I was so angry, I nearly threw it away. But then I decided it would be kinder to bury it here. It's under the old pine tree.
The old man began to cry.
Oh, well, do you think I could have that tree to remind me of my faithful friend?
I don't see why not. It's been dead for quite a while.
So the old man took the tree home and found there was enough good wood in it to make a mortar for pounding rice cakes. All that day he worked on the mortar, and then in the evening his wife put some rice in it so that they could make rice cakes in memory of Jiro. But then something strange happened. Rice cakes started pouring out of the mortar. More and more and more. The old couple realized that it was Jiro's spirit which was doing this. They were the most delicious rice cakes they had ever tasted, and they silently thanked their lost companion. Now, the nasty neighbor wondered what had happened to the tree. And when he heard the pounding, he crept around and peeped through their shutters. He saw the pile of rice cakes and determined to get hold of the magic mortar. Early next morning, he called on the old couple again.
Good morning, old man. How are you today?
The old man was silent.
I've been thinking about your dog. I was a bit hasty in killing it, and I think I should pay homage to its memory too. I wonder if I could borrow your mortar for the morning.
Well, it's the only one we've got. Will you promise to bring it back today?
Oh, yes, of course. Don't worry.
So the old man gave him the mortar. But sunset came, and the neighbor had not returned it. Suddenly, the old couple noticed smoke drifting across their garden from the neighbor's house.
Oh dear, I wonder what's happening. I'd better go next door and see.
The old man hurried round to the neighbor's. The neighbor came to the door and said,
Yes, what do you want?
Well, you promised to bring the mortar back today. And I've just noticed smoke coming from your house.
The mortar. That useless thing. It only made rice cakes full of cockroaches and spiders and flies. So I had to burn it.
You've burnt it? But that was a wonderful mortar. Oh, dear. Well, do you think I could have the ashes?
I don't see why not. They're no use to me. Help yourself. They're over there.
So the old man picked up some of the ashes and carried them home. But just as he reached his house, he tripped up and dropped some of them. There was a strong autumn wind blowing that day, and it blew the ashes all over his trees. Immediately, they sprang into blossom. The old man couldn't believe his eyes. It was just like spring. He threw more ashes on his other trees, and the same thing happened again. His wife heard him laughing joyfully and rushed out.
Look what Jiro's done for us this time.
His wife clapped her hands in joy, and together they danced under the trees. The story soon spread throughout the country. And one day, a heavy knock came at their door. It was a knight from the court of the Shining Prince. The old couple bowed down low before him.
My lord has sent me here to fetch you with your famous ashes. He needs your help because his favorite cherry tree is dying. Please come with me at once.
Of course, sir,
stammered the old man. He got into the waiting carriage, and off they sped. When they arrived at the palace, they went straight into the garden. The prince was there with all his courtiers, looking sadly up at the withered cherry tree.
Please do what you can, old man.
Yes, your majesty.
The old man picked up his pot of ashes, climbed up a ladder, and scattered the ashes amongst the branches. Immediately, the tree was covered with sweet-smelling blossoms. The prince jumped up with pleasure, and everyone cheered the old man.
Old man, your fine deed makes me very happy. I'm going to grant you a special title, the royal gardener who makes cherry trees bloom.
And he gave the old man a purse full of gold and a box of cream cakes for his wife. When the royal gardener arrived home, everyone in the village was there to congratulate him. He offered thanks to the spirit of the dog and vowed never to forget him. But next door, the nasty neighbor, jealous of the old man's good fortune, was thinking up another nasty plan.
It's lucky for me I kept some of those ashes. Now I can go to the palace and get some gold too.
So he set out the next day, arrived at the palace gate, and announced himself.
I'm the senior royal gardener who makes cherry trees bloom.
He was shown in, and the prince said,
Are you sure you are the man with that title? I thought there was only one. Oh, yes, your majesty, but that old man only came here as my pupil. I am his teacher. Well, in that case, you must be able to produce even bigger flowers.
The prince led him into the garden, and all the courtiers came out to see what would happen this time. The nasty neighbor climbed up the ladder and sprinkled the ashes all over the cherry tree. Nothing happened. He sprinkled some more, and at once the lovely flowers began to fade. The petals dropped, the leaves shriveled and fell from the tree, and soon it was all withered again. Even worse, everybody in the garden was covered with nasty, sticky ashes. The prince was furious.
Throw that man into prison and never, never let him out.
And there the nasty neighbor remained until he, too, withered and died. But the real royal gardener who makes cherry trees bloom, lived for many more years, happy, rich, and loved and respected throughout the land. And every morning, he prayed at the little shrine under the cherry trees in his garden for the happiness of Jiro's spirit.